So leading strand, lagging strand, why are there different strands? How can you tell which is which? Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor, and let's talk about leading and lagging strands. So of course, we're talking about DNA replication here. So we've got an origin of replication, typically just one in prokaryotes, many in eukaryotes. And around that origin, we're going to denature some DNA, basically separating those two strands of DNA so that we can use those strands as template strands. This is going to form a replication bubble. So our replication bubble is going to consist of two replication forks. And replication is bidirectional. So it's going to happen in both directions into each of the two replication forks. But there are differences in how each new strand is synthesized. But why? This is because the two strands in a DNA molecule are antiparallel. And I'm not going to go into a ton of detail on this. I have a video on that if you want to check it out. But essentially, it means that a single DNA strand has directionality. It has a 5' end and a 3' end. And when it's paired up with another strand to make a double-stranded DNA molecule, the strands run in opposite directions, opposite 5' and 3' directions. So this might create just a teeny problem when it's time to replicate the DNA, because we've got DNA strands running in two directions, but DNA polymerase only works one way. It can only add on to the 3' end of a strand. So we can only grow the strand 5' to 3'. Now, for one of our template strands, this is absolutely no problem just based on its orientation. We can easily start to construct a new antiparallel strand that is going to have its 3' end into the fork. So again, we can grow it into the fork. So this strand is synthesized continuously, meaning we're going to lay down one RNA primer and get to work. And this strand is called the leading strand. Now for the problem child, right? The other template strand is oriented in the opposite direction. So when we start to create a new strand antiparallel to that one, it's not going to work out quite as easily. The 3' end of the newly synthesized strand will be facing away from the fork. So the way to get around that, here's our replication fork, is to open up our fork, create a little strand, a little fragment, open up the fork more, create another fragment. So it can seem a little bit tricky because our little fragments are going to be synthesized away from the fork. But the overall growth of the strand is into the replication fork. And I'm sure you've guessed it that we're talking about making the lagging strand. So the lagging strand is going to be synthesized discontinuously. So in lots of little stops and starts, lots of little pieces. We call those pieces Okazaki fragments. So each replication fork will have one leading strand and one lagging strand. Which is going to depend on the orientation, the directionality of the template strands. The leading strand will be oriented 5' to 3' into the fork, right? Its 3' end will be into the fork, and that can be synthesized continuously. Whereas the lagging strand will have its 3' end facing away from the fork and will have to be synthesized discontinuously in Okazaki fragments that will be joined together to make one strand. Remember that a replication fork is just one half of a replication bubble. And so in the bubble, we're gonna have two leading strands and two lagging strands. And again, DNA replication is going to occur. We're gonna have synthesis in both directions, bidirectional. So, drop me a like if this helped a little bit with clearing up leading strands and lagging strands. Hopefully, you can identify who's who now. Check out my website for tutoring resources and subscribe for more biology content from me. and I will see you next time.